Put more love in your life. Contact Adoption Information Service.
Is an old-time cop. Haven is the future cop. He's a robot.
Not a robot. A biosynthetic android.
Steadfast, loyal, trustworthy.
Yeah, I had a 36 Chevy like that once.
He knows how to follow orders.
Come with me. I've got your cover.
But this rookie has a lot to learn.
Oh, no!
The Future Cop, starring Ernest Borgnine and Michael Shannon.
I like my chicken finger licking good.
I like my chicken finger licking good.
If it's not finger licking good chicken, it's not Kentucky Fried Chicken. And it's not my chicken, and nobody can make me eat it.
I like my chicken finger licking good.
Real goodness from Kentucky Fried Chicken.
I've used regular aspirin tablets, but this pain reliever, Excedrin, works significantly better for me. And it also worked better in two medical studies on pain other than headache, pain that could be measured more readily. Why did Excedrin work better? Tablet for tablet, the Excedrin Extra Strength formula provides more pain reliever, more total strength than regular aspirin. Next time you're in pain, try Excedrin, the Extra Strength pain reliever. It's made stronger than regular aspirin, and it could work better for you.
Put on a pair of Cool Rays. You won't believe your eyes. Hey, hey.
Hey, hey, hey. Foxy!
Cool Ray has 125 eye-catching styles. New polarized mirror and gradient lenses. Tortoise stripe frames. All with the glare protection only the polarized lens gives you.
Ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta.
Cool Ray sunglasses. You won't believe your eyes.
If you really like this mouthwash, then you should know about something new. Listermint. And if you wonder how a mouthwash called Listermint will taste, you should know that a panel of regular Scope users found Listermint just as good tasting as Scope. A new Listermint is test proven more effective than Scope at keeping your breath fresh and clean.
New Listermint mouthwash tastes as good as it works.
Tastes as good as it works.
Five pursuit on a 201. He's getting away. Hey, can you get us a chopper?
You gotta be kidding, Cleaver. You really think they're gonna spring a chopper for you on a routine car theft?
In the streets, and we are losing. The average police officer is a foot soldier, functioning with the tools of trench warfare in an atomic age. We're suggesting there's a better way. we are proposing to you is the policeman of the future.
This is the police. The entire building is surrounded. Give up. Come out with your hands over your heads.
Hey, we got one of your pigs, man. You hear me? You got a deal with us.
No deal. Come on out or we're coming in after you.
I kill the pig and dump his body in the street.
We waste him. We got no chance at all. We're gonna die here.
We got no chance anyway. All right, now kill him. Now let the people know that we're willing to die for what we believe. Now Duvall said it. The blood has got to run in the streets before the masses awake.
Actually, I think you'll find that Duvall's exact quote was that the specter of blood arouses the masses. But in context, he continued to make the point that such an emotional arousal only feeds their emotion and not their reason. And that only a reasoning proletariat can ultimately destroy the power structure.
Yeah, what about Jackman? He died nailing those pigs to the wall.
A popular misconception. Actually, he died of a stomach disorder months after the actual shooting. In point of fact, his last words actually refuted his early stand.
A robot?
No, Commissioner. A functioning biosynthetic android.
Haven. What does the name stand for?
Nothing. Just Haven.
Somehow it all seems like something out of 1984.
1984 is only 8 years away. Think about it, Councilman. Will we still be using the police techniques of the 30s?
That proves nothing. Nothing. I can count on one thumb the number of times one of my beat cops is going to come across a band of those oddballs. One on one. That's where it's at.
Watch. I'm sure this will satisfy you, Commissioner. Let me demonstrate the possibilities of Haven in a typical one-on-one street situation.
And I blow you away. Now, very slowly open the cash drawer and empty it.
I'm so glad to see you. I've never been so frightened in my whole life. Oh.
Yeah, get away from me, man. I didn't do nothing. Just get away from me, man.
Ma'am, you're under arrest for attempted robbery and assault with a deadly weapon. You have the right to remain silent. If you give up the right to remain silent...
Questions? If there are none, then I suggest those of you who can adjourn with me to the lab for a summary.
Now, that last one had to be rigged. There's no way any cop could figure for the old lady.
No, not rigged. Overstated for effect, perhaps. If a paraffin test had been made on the lady's hands, it would have proven if she had fired the gun. Your lab men would have taken 24 hours to achieve this. Haven's sensors accomplished it in something under 3 seconds.
So we take a little longer, so what?
Tell me something, Commissioner. Given all the time you want, would you have held the old lady?
Thank you.
minutes. This is your most important test, Haven. Are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
I'm sure some of you may have unstated doubts as to the validity of our demonstrations. I can assure you, though the situations may seem artificial to you, to Haven, they were quite real. And his reactions to them were equally real.
He's never going to cut it out there on the street. No way. They'll chew him up.
Try him.
Hi.
Why doesn't he blink?
Ask him.
Don't you ever blink?
Doesn't everyone? Most people blink an average of 22 times a minute. I blink an acceptable minimum of 11.6 times a minute. Of course, crystal timed.
Oh, that's nice. What do I need with a 170-pound wristwatch?
I don't think we've met. My name's Haven.
What do you think I do, shake hands with every crummy, fat-faced rookie? Who do you think I am?
You're Police Commissioner Foreman, and I understand your position completely.
So? And do you understand the code 2703?
Armed robbery, officer down.
How many duty hours in the second watch come in?
Four on, one off. Two on, one off.
Suspect interrogation, how many consecutive hours?
Five with counsel, four without.
Code 773.
Ambulance needed.
Code 817.
Request additional unit.
No good. No good. That's incomplete.
If it does not follow a code 2703, officer must specify reason.
Right.
He looks vaguely familiar.
Interesting point. We spent a lot of time on the face. In 50 years, when people begin to accept them as law enforcement officers, they probably won't even need a face. But for now, we tried to concentrate on certain specific qualities. Quiet strength, inner tranquility, emotional reassurance. He's actually a composite of James Arness, Paul Newman, and a young Lorne Green.
Okay. Suspect interrogation. You're working this joker over, right? You've almost got him. You lean in close to nail him, and then all of a sudden...
Would you care to complete the question?
Come on. Make a blink go.
Haven, you can release.
Come on, will you?
You can release, Haven.
Haven? Release.
And I assume the question has no logical conclusion.
None! Let go, will you?
I never said he was perfect. Just a prototype model.
It was nice to meet you, sir.
Get him away from me.
It might be wise if you...
Oh. Yeah, me too. Nice talking to you.
I don't think you should have done that.
I'm sorry. I sensed hostility. Was I wrong?
We'll work on it. It's a question of identifying individual emotional responses, huh? And finding the special keys to making that individual like you. You must remember, there's more than one way to skin a cat.
Actually, there are 37 ways.
Are you really suggesting I let that clockwork maniac out on the street with my men?
We're suggesting that you try. 1 8-hour trial shift. What we can learn from that will help us with further programming.
No way. No way, not a chance.
If the newspapers were ever to get a hold of this...
They don't need ever to know. No one needs to know outside the confines of this room. All we want is a test. If Haven can't function on the street, we want to be the first to know.
Are you seriously considering this?
Every journey begins with the first step.
Oh, save that bull for your constituents. You want that crazy robot out there shooting up the streets?
Not a robot. A biosynthetic android. And Haven is incapable of violence. He has a built-in fail-safe system programmed against it.
Let's confer on this. I think we're going to be able to work all this out. As one duty day with Haven working with an average police officer, and we'll evaluate the entire program based on that.
Are you ready to go along with it, Commissioner?
Well, I've never been one to stand in the way of progress. And I think I've got the perfect average officer. Hardworking, dedicated, intelligent.
Come on. Hey, that's great.
Look at that, huh?
That's marvelous. One more time.
Cleaver, come on, let's go, man.
Okay, all right. Warm it up. I'll be right there, dearie.
No way, man. It's your turn to drive.
Hey, you forgetting about Thursday?
Well, Friday wipes that out.
Come on,
remember?
Man.
You spent that extra half an hour stuffing your face. Now, come on, you gonna drive or not?
Oh, man, you could be the biggest pain in the...
One box, five. Cleaver, come in, please.
Hey, if that's a 604...
Yeah, I know. Tell him we got a flat.
One box, five. Come in.
You got Cleaver with you? Or is he sacked out somewhere?
Both.
And tell him he's wanted for orientation duty.
Cleaver, you gotta be kidding.
Commissioner Foreman is coming on.
Cleaver, are you there?
Yes, sir.
How you doing, old tiger? You still hanging in there?
I'm doing all right.
I was just thinking about you today. Remembering the old days. Wondering whether good old Cleaver was still around chewing up the streets.
Yeah, good old Cleaver. Still around. He's still in grade.
Well, we gotta do something about that one of these days. In the meantime, I got a special little job of rookie orientation for you.
Oh, now listen, Commissioner, I gotta tell you, you know, it's been a long time since I've been out with a rookie.
Now, don't you worry, Cleaver. It's gonna work out fine. All you gotta do is just be yourself.
Okay. I'll be myself. How do you like that?
Maybe we should wait just a few more days. There are too many things he doesn't know about in that world out there. He's incapable of lying about himself.
You'll have to learn.
I don't want him to learn those things.
I'm sorry. It's time to leave. Now, you'll be going out with an Officer Cleaver in car 1, Fox 5. Would you like us to go with you?
No, I'll be fine.
Out of sight.
Ah, shut up.
You were a rookie, man. What I wouldn't give to see that.
What would you give to see yourself with a bent ear?
A bent ear.
Hi. You must be Officer Cleaver. I think we're going to be working together.
Get in. You drive, Fumblebutt.
Of course.
And slowly, very slowly. I gotta rest.
Of course.
Now you wanna know about Cleaver, huh? Well, I tell you, I've been working with him for 23 years. Now you can't get him to jump for a drunken disorderly or a husband and wife squabble, but he's got 3 beyond the call of duty commendations. And a Medal of Valor. Keeps him in a cigar box in his rooming house. Bottom line is, he's the best cop I've ever known. I wouldn't work with anyone else. But where's it written that I have to like him?
Man, I'm hungry.
Aren't we required to put in 3 hours before a meal period?
Stuff that noise. Make a left, pull over there by that restaurant.
question for you. What are you going to have? The number three. Okay, got you. Usual?
What else?
How about you, sweetie?
Just coffee, thanks.
I'm tired, kid. So I'll make it easy. We don't take no 607s or 304s. Just tell them we got a flat tire or the car's disabled or we're on a relief stop, whichever you want, huh?
I'd be glad to try to handle them by myself if it's all right with you.
Hey, Fumblebutt, don't talk. Just listen. There's no points here. Do you just sit until I tell you to jump? And then you jump. Is that loud and clear?
Yes, sir. Would you like me to wait in the car and monitor calls?
Did I tell you to?
No, sir.
Then just sit and shut up. I hear the calls I gotta hear.
Don't worry about Cleaver. He's got a mother's ear. Well, I heard about it, but I still don't believe it. Cleaver on rookie duty? Who is he?
Tell him who you are, kid.
My name's Haven. I'm very pleased to meet you.
Catch the Steeler game last night?
Tank job. They didn't even want the game.
Oh, sure, sure. You still owe me a fin.
Yeah.
Give me a cup of coffee, will you, please, Doc?
Gotcha.
It doesn't smell like coffee.
What are you training to be? A grass hound?
Grass hound?
It's a narcotics dog they use to smell out marijuana.
Oh, right. Grass hound. I have that now.
Let me tell you about Cleaver's coffee.
Big mouth.
It's a kind of brand that they brew, especially for him. You got it? Brew. You follow pro football?
I don't think so.
Well, you got to know to pick up some loose change is to bet against Cleaver here, and I'm not... You don't think so? What's that supposed to mean?
I don't believe it's included in my programming.
Programming? What program?
Programming is the... methodology used.
Hold it.
1 box 5. We got another one of your 201s, Cleaver.
Jump! Here you go, Frank. I'll tell you when to drive. Box 5 in pursuit on 201. You got any further readings?
Too late. Looks like they've lost him heading south off the interchange.
But if they're sure that there was a Porsche 911?
Confirmed.
Keep losing these jokers. Any TD spottings in the area?
One just came in. TD 28 reported sighting a speeding Porsche 0314 to the truck storage depot.
Got it.
Will you give it up, Cleaver? We got no confirmation it's even the same car.
Stuff confirmation. Over and out.
You got all that, kid?
201 is grand theft automobile. TD 28 is a traffic detail on routine control. 314 is a two-lane secondary road running south-southeast of the Civic Center. 911 would be the stolen vehicle. A six-cylinder Porsche with a 2,700cc displacement. Air-cooled, single overhead cams, hydraulic lifters, five-speed stick shift. Optional.
operation, kid. They work a lot of cities. They only hit Porsche 911s. They rework them and ship them out of the country.
Doesn't that come under federal authority?
Ah, you can stop that federal noise. I don't care what they do in Duluth. This is my turf. Besides, they also brought down a cop that got too close. Better get on the pipe, kid.
Pipe?
A horn. A radio.
Yes, sir.
Tell them to send out those jokers from the lab. Maybe they can make something out of these tracks. By the time those clowns get here, that Porsche will probably be stripped onto a Volkswagen.
If it's of any help, that tread is a Michelin XWX.
Huh?
Factory issue on the Porsche 911. The reverse tread is very distinctive.
Okay, go ahead. Compacted before, kid?
No, they've only told me about them.
Well, come on, I'll give you a guided tour some other time. Me.
I've got your cover.
Dry hair that gives it body and shine. That's what made me a Breck girl.
My hair is normal. Breck for normal hair leaves it fresh and beautiful. That's what made me a Breck girl.
My hair is oily. And Breck for oily hair makes it clean and bouncy. That's what made me a Breck girl.
Three kinds of Breck shampoo. One of them is all you need to be a Breck girl.
And now for my final selection.
I'll munch to that.
I think I can live without this one.
I'll munch to that.
Fritos brand corn chips. Nothing munches like them, nothing tastes like them. They're America's munchy favorite.
Wow, that lighting sure is scary.
I'll munch to that.
The nicest way to start a day is with fruit and cereal. Until the fruit's all gone and there's nothing left but cereal. So smart fruit and cereal lovers eat Post Raisin Bran. Post mixes wholesome wheat and bran with so many plump, chewy raisins, you can get fruit in every spoonful, right down to the last spoonful. And if you're a fruit and cereal lover, it's never too late to learn. Post Raisin Bran, the fruit and cereal lover's cereal.
Maxine, you're switching from Instant Maxwell House.
Found something that smells better and tastes better.
Come on.
Just smell Instant Maxwell House. Now, take a whiff of this new coffee.
That is better. Smells fresh. But taste is what I go for.
Taste.
Tastes fresher.
It's new Instant Maxwell House. Fresh aroma, fresher flavor. I think I'll have a cup.
New Instant Maxwell House. Now in colonial storage jars.
The Haven's malfunctioning. You told me. You promised it wouldn't happen.
Get the van.
What if he's damaged? What if he hurts someone? His fail-safe system's incomplete.
The former, a conceivable possibility. The latter, a total improbability. I took the liberty of putting blank cartridges in his gun.
It's all right, kid. It's all right. I understand.
They told you about me?
I don't have to be told. I froze the first time, too.
Actually, a freezing of gear mechanism. I believe it was an intermittent programming malfunction.
Look, forget about those police academy programs, kid. You're in the real world now. Now, look. I've got them spotted. There's just two of them.
No, three.
Three?
Yes, two are carrying .38 caliber detective specials. The third has a clip-loaded rifle. 18 rounds expended. Correction, 19.
Forget the arithmetic, kid. We're pinned down. We gotta separate. Look, I'm gonna make a break for it and draw their fire.
.22. That should exhaust his clip.
Hey! Come back, you idiot! They could be reloading! Come back!
They would not carry additional ammunition unless they had anticipated a confrontation. Not a logical assumption. You are under arrest. Come out with your hands raised above your heads.
How do you like that? Get him up. Get him up.
Drop your weapons. You will please turn around and place your hands above your head.
Get over here. Who are you?
We're from Synthetronics. We designed him.
What?
May I explain?
Yeah, I think you better.
Haven, can you hear me now? You did very well. I'm very proud of you.
He understands.
Nobody really understands you, only me.
No, he understands. He does. Does.
It is therefore vital for our test purposes the existence of this prototype remain a secret.
Prototype?
Haven is still an experimental model. Like a special model that a car company designs without ever intending to put on the streets.
Well, what do you know? That police academy must be going nuts. Yeah, well, if he's so special, how come he's such a fumble butt?
Fumble?
A fumble butt. An eight ball. You know, like when he goes to shoot, he can't hit the side of a barn.
His gun was loaded with blanks.
What?
If you wanted, Haven could have been designed to be incapable of missing.
If I wanted?
At any range.
Well, he was pretty good at tire tracks.
Exactly. It's like having a mobile computer with you at all times.
You can forget that computer bit.
Think of it this way. For a police officer like yourself, he is the perfect adjunct. The perfect partner. Steadfast, loyal, trustworthy. Oh, it would mean so much to him. Help him. Teach him all the things that we can't.
Will he be okay?
We hope so.
Because if there's anybody I can talk to for you, I mean, you know, like a relative of his, sometimes it's easier when another cop breaks the news, you know what I mean?
But actually, he has no real relationships. Oh, there was a data computer that he became quite close to during his early programming.
A data computer? What am I talking about? He's just a machine.
Oh, Officer Cleaver.
Hey, lady, you got a problem with him? Mail him back to the factory. Maybe you still got a warranty on him.
Philistine.
Better not tell Haven he's been rejected.
I've never lied to him.
I'm not suggesting a lie. Merely a temporary erasing of fact.
Repeat. Your readout is unacceptable. Revise. Rephrase.
Will he be all right?
He may be more damaged than I thought. He's making totally illogical requests for additional programming.
But that doesn't seem illogical.
But he wants it to be on professional football.
At a pretty interesting little performance car, Opel Isuzu. It's got a four-cylinder overhead cam Hemi engine, and it's a ball to drive.
There comes one!
But listen to this. An Opel Isuzu with standard four-speed transmission got an estimated 36 miles per gallon in the EPA highway test, 23 in the city. Opel Isuzu. Better not pass it up at your Buick Opel dealer.
Occasional indigestion. You may be feeling it a little more often than you used to. It's a fact of life. Some things you once could eat and drink without a problem now may be giving you indigestion. Pepto-Bismol relieves indigestion. It coats and soothes, helps relieve the irritation, helps your stomach return to normal, helps protect it against further abuse. Pepto-Bismol relieves indigestion.
It's history, it's hoopla, it's the greatest show in American politics. But there's more than one way to cover a convention. ABC News gets to the heart of a convention. Everything that makes news, all the historic events, you'll get the full impact of convention excitement and drama. So watch ABC News and get to the heart of the convention.
1 hour from now on ABC.
Does the lady have a secret? Not anymore. The machine that measures emotions gave her away.
After 6.5 years, I thought I knew a little better.
Jim Peck hosts the game where husbands and wives learn the truth about each other with the machine that can catch you in a lie. The hot seat.
What is your most romantic moment?
Tomorrow at 12, 11 Central, 10 Mountain on ABC.
Is proud of you.
Well, they would be if they know what you did for them. Sit down, sit down.
Thanks. Well, it wasn't anything.
Don't be so modest. We all know you held the line.
Held the what?
Held the line against automation. And you did it working undercover, so to speak. An unknown soldier in a never-ending war.
Yeah, I guess so. But, I mean, what did I really do?
Why, you proved that that thing, whatever they call it...
Oh, a haven.
Couldn't function under real street conditions.
Well, you know, he wasn't so terrible. I mean, I've seen a lot of rookies that blew it a lot worse than on their first time out.
Ah, you're a good man, Cleaver. The best. You and Bundy, backbone of the force. Oh, by the way, Bundy doesn't know anything about this little experiment, does he?
Well, no, you see, everything happened so fast, I didn't get a chance to tell him.
Keep it that way. Better for morale.
Send it, Officer Bundy.
I got a little surprise for you boys. I just want to show you that the department doesn't forget. Officer Bundy, come on in and sit down. And I've been checking up on the files on you boys. And I think it's about time we got you out of the pits. I mean, 21 years ought to be enough for anybody.
23.
Must be a computer error. But no matter. After today, we're moving you both up to tactical.
Hey, that's fantastic.
No way.
Cleaver, tactical. Off the streets, off call, special assignments, open duty.
We like the street. You can step. You can give tactical to some other jokers.
Cleaver!
No way, sir.
Bundy, it's yours if you want it.
No way.
Sure, sure. I know how many times we talked about it, but I'm not about to leave Cleaver. Now, Bundy, don't hang up. Well, what do you want me to say? I figured you'd understand. Now, Bunny, don't hang up. Bunny, you hear me? Yes, yes, I know who I'm married to. Do we have to go through that again? Bunny, how long we been married now? 16 years? Okay, 17. I see you maybe 4 hours every night, 1 hour in the morning, and maybe some more a couple of times a week. But I've been with Cleaver 8 hours a day for 23 years. That's got to mean something. Do I want tactical? Oh, man, do I want it. Yeah. But what do I do about Cleaver? I mean, what do I tell him? Bunny, I don't want to hear that kind of talk. Bunny, now listen to me. Don't hang up.
Thank you.
What'll you have to eat?
Nothing. Just bring me some coffee.
Where's Bundy?
Where's Bundy? Where's Bundy? Big deal. I can't come in here once without Bundy. 23 years. Always yammering at me in that car. You'd think just once he might have said something he really meant.
You okay, Cleaver?
Did you ever work the street?
Now, what's that supposed to mean?
I always wanted to work the street. Even when I played football, I was a tackle. That's what I always wanted to be. Not a quarterback. Not an end. Just a tackle. You knew what you had to know, and you did what you had to do, and that's what counted.
Hey, kid, don't beat it to death.
That lousy machine, it's busted.
Busted my foot.
Hey, take a look.
Treat them right. There's one thing about a machine. You treat them right, they'll never mess you up.
To new programming analysis.
Oh. Well, I just happened to be coming by here, and I thought I'd just drop in to see how he was.
Of course. You're blocking his sight line.
Oh. He looks okay.
He is. You'd like to have him back, wouldn't you?
Well, I never said that.
Take him. Even for a few days. You won't be sorry. You can depend on him. Sometimes I think he's the only thing you can depend on.
Yeah, I had a 36 Chevy like that once.
Steadfast, loyal, trustworthy.
Would he have to yammer at me all the time?
Yammer?
Yeah, you know, talk to me while I'm trying to rest in the car.
Oh, that could be arranged. An audio cutoff switch activated by a verbal command.
How's that again?
Haven would automatically stop talking on your order.
On my order?
As simple as saying, terminate audio cycle phase.
Huh?
Terminate audio phase?
Hmm.
How about just phase off?
Phase off? I like that.
One more feature. How would you like to see the programming he's currently working on?
Hey. Quit trying to sell me, will you? I'm not here just buying some new dishwasher, you know.
I know you know that.
Oh.
If I didn't, I wouldn't be trying to sell you.
All right. What else you got?
Professional football. He's up to Super Bowl VII. In 10 minutes, he'll have it all completely transcribed. 15 if you want all the instant replays.
going out with that rookie for another week. You gotta be kidding.
I've been thinking I might even stay on orientation duty. I like rookies.
How come you never told me that?
Because you never stopped talking long enough to listen.
You sure this hasn't got anything to do with me and tactical?
No, it's got nothing to do with you and tactical. It's got to do with me. I figure that one day you got to start paying your dues. And if we don't bring along these kids, who will?
Doesn't that guy ever eat?
If you weren't always stuffing your mouth, maybe we could have cracked more action.
Me stuffing my mouth?
Look, I haven't got time to make small talk with you. We got to get back to work.
What work? You're all stiff.
There's a special assignment. Top level. And just until I wrap up the action in that Porsche ring.
You couldn't even wrap up your own laundry by yourself.
Look, are you just going to sit there yammering at me? Or are you going to give me some action on the biking game?
Well, you never learn, do you? All right, I'll take the Packers and 12 points.
The Packers and 12?
Yeah.
$10, you got the Packers and 14 and a half.
Yeah, but the line is 12.
The even money line. We want 7-5.
We? What we?
What are you kidding me at working it together?
Hey, what's so special about that joker of yours?
Well, never mind about him. I just want to know whether you want the action.
Be careful. Don't handle the merchandise unless you intend to buy.
Is it for sale?
Isn't everything?
No.
You know, you got fantastic eyes.
I do.
I'll bet I know your sign.
Is there one showing?
Well, how about that? Finally, a cop with a sense of humor. You just gotta be a Taurus.
I do.
But you can't bet the points and the odds.
Well, now, if this is too much for your pea head to handle, just tell me.
You got it.
Hey, honey, you see my partner?
That creep. I told him to go take a walk.
Take a walk? What'd he do?
Look, I've been put down by experts. I don't need that kind of mumbo-jumbo.
Mumbo-jumbo?
Yeah. Give me all this weird jive about circuits and relays.
Well, what'd you say to him?
All I did was ask what turned him on.
Oh.
Enough to clean his permanent press. Fab with Borax gets out the tough dirt and leaves our clothes smelling fresh. And I sure don't need extra help for that. For me, Fab with Real Borax does that all alone.
I like my chicken finger licking good.
I like my chicken finger licking
Nobody knows the 11 herbs and spices the Colonel uses to make his original recipe chicken. And nobody knows how to make it like this. And nobody knows how to enjoy it like I do.
I like my chicken finger-licking good.
Real goodness from Kentucky Fried Chicken.
How about a movie, lovely lady?
This bar is dark, but with a flick of my beak, I can see your ahead.
Coffee, tea, or a flick of my bick?
Flick of the bick, sir? Oh, a flick of the bick, sir?
Why just light up when you can flick your bick? It's smooth, easy on the thumb, and you get thousands of flicks from a single bick. The Bick Butane.
Stop flicking your bick.
Future Cop, starring Ernest Borgnine and Michael Shannon, will continue in a moment. Watch the National League battle the American League in the 1976 All-Star Game tomorrow on 8.
Pack your bags, Chicago. Trailways is having a big travel sale. Right now, you save over half the regular coach airfare on Trailways round trip to these cities. Trailways to L.A. or San Francisco, save $180. Trailways to Boston, save $104. Save $94 to Denver, $94 to New York, $83 to Washington, D.C., and $100 to Dallas. During Trailways travel sale, I tell you, half the airfare ain't half bad.
Back when broadcasting was just beginning, this Midwestern kid decided to give up the clarinet and give it a whirl as a newscaster. In those days, everyone wore a bow tie, except Faye Flynn. Even then, he was different, distinctive, with his own style of reporting the news. It's a style that people took to, from his early days on radio to anchoring one of Chicago's first TV news programs, to that fateful day he joined Joel Daly on Eyewitness News. Faye Flynn. He kind of gives you a sense of history when he gives you the news.
We return now to our feature, Future Cop.
Says you can't make it, man.
Yeah.
Make it?
Yeah. Put it in the basket.
Sorry, I was supposed to be taking a walk.
Come on. Give him back the ball.
Thanks.
Listen, kid. You gotta stop talking to people like that waitress when I'm not around. You understand what I mean?
I only told her the truth. It's the way I'm programmed.
Yeah. But someday, I'll explain the truth. But until then, let me do the talking, huh? Come on.
On 3rd and Grove. And the last was on the 400 block of Hazel. And that's it. The location of every Porsche 911 car theft we've got on record.
What does that do for you?
Takes you out of this world and puts you in a better one, kid.
Really? A better world?
No. It isn't really better.
I'm having difficulty computing that response.
Don't strain your tubes, kid. Just compute what all that means.
Yes, sir. Well, from the data received so far, the wrecking yard appears to be at a median distance center point of all recorded car thefts.
Well, hold it. A median distance center point.
Right.
Uh-huh. That means that those jokers in that car just didn't duck in there trying to get away from us. Sure. That must be their headquarters. That's why they started shooting when we got too close.
Exactly.
Go ahead.
And given the limiting factor that the Porsche is a two-seater, the two bearing concealable weapons, i.e. handguns, must have been involved in the actual street robbery of the vehicle. The logical assumption, therefore...
Well, hold it. Back it up. Well, the logical assumption, therefore, is that,
Go ahead.
The logical assumption, therefore, is that third, the one who escaped with the rifle, must have been in charge of the operation of the wrecking yard.
Of course. The head honcho.
Definition, please.
The guy in charge. What's the matter? Didn't they teach you anything?
I've been programmed for most of the available police vernacular for suspects. Jokers, clowns, turkeys, creeps, losers, bad guys.
Phase off. We'll talk about it later. Right now, we got places to go and things to do, buddy. Let's see, where'd I put it? Go ahead. Don't just sit there. Say something. Tell me about why you think Tarkington won't make it out with the Packers. Phase on.
Tarkington is not basically a straight drop-back passer. His key third down and long calls, a rollout to the left pass to the right. This is an extremely difficult maneuver. However, the Packers' cornerback on that side is left-handed, giving him an equally unique skill in defending against a first angle down and out pass.
Impound? Oh, no.
May I be of assistance?
You can tear it down for all I care.
I'm afraid I don't have that capability. However.
Now, the first thing we do is dig out that car. You go to the right, I'll go to the left.
May I be of further assistance?
Oh, sure. Go ahead. Why not?
I am equipped with infrared sensors. The stolen Porsche would have been the last vehicle driven in here. It would, therefore, theoretically, emit the most amount of residual heat in the yard.
What do you mean, heat? They brought it in yesterday.
They are exceptional sensors, developed originally...
All right. Quit your bragging and just do what you're supposed to do.
Would you stand behind me, please? This way, please.
Keep on going. And when you get to China, you can send me a postcard.
May I have further clarification on that request?
Oh, just shut up. Look, better still, go find that compactor and really get yourselves together.
It will take me a moment to properly evaluate these requests. However, I can say now that I am not programmed to leave another law enforcement officer in a possible jeopardy situation.
Jeopardy? What jeopardy? From who?
The third... hauncher?
Whatever would he want to come back here for?
To remove his fingerprints.
Boy, you really burned a condenser. The Joker's prints are all over this yard.
Those prints would not be incriminating evidence.
Uh-huh.
Only the ones left in the stolen vehicle.
Uh-huh. Okay. Let's go. Where? In there?
My sensors indicate the primary source of low-level residual infrared comes from within.
Why don't you tell me that before?
You never asked.
Are you sure?
The censors never lie. However, there is another...
Okay, cool it. That's enough of that jazz. Come on. I can see you got a lot in common. Hold still there, fumble butt. Now look, I don't want to hear no more bull about heat sources or jeopardy or anything else. I'll go out and find that cow myself.
But I have your gun. If my gun has blood...
Ah, phase off. Freeze. Right there. Now, don't you move another gear until I come back for you. Do you understand?
Plain potatoes make for a plain meal. So when my budget calls for a plain meat, I dress it up with Betty Crocker au gratin potatoes. Tender slices of real russet potato in a golden smooth cheddary sauce, rich and tangy. So good with Frankfurters, hamburger, or chicken.
Great meal, Mom.
Take a plain meat and make the whole meal not so plain with Betty Crocker au gratin potatoes, one of five plain meat potatoes from Betty Crocker.
Introducing new better-tasting Diet Pepsi. So now, you can do it with more taste.
Do it with new Diet Pepsi. Bigger, brighter taste.
Now, Diet Pepsi-Cola's got it. A bigger, brighter cola taste. And still only one little calorie.
You can do it with more taste. One calorie Diet Pepsi. Bigger, brighter taste.
Do it with new Diet Pepsi. Bigger, brighter taste.
There's more than one way to cover a convention. ABC News brings you the heart of the convention. Everything that makes news, all the historic events. You'll get the full impact of all the convention drama and excitement. Join Harry Reasoner, Howard K. Smith, Senator Barry Goldwater, Lou Harris, and get to the heart of the convention.
30 minutes from now on ABC.
This fall, the movies on ABC will present Paul Newman and Robert Redford in one of the most popular movies of all time.
Think you's enough dynamite there, Bush?
The two most notorious outlaws the West ever produced.
They're very good!
And Catherine Ross as the woman who wouldn't give them away.
Oh.
They just couldn't touch Butch Cassidy and the Sundance Kid. This fall, the best movies on television are still on ABC.
Haven. Haven.
We salvaged everything we could.
Salvaged?
You heard him. They took out all the junk they could. Restoring all his memory banks would involve a great deal of money. More than we have at our disposal.
We could probably totally reprogram him. Erase all current memory banks.
Well, you mean he'd remember nothing?
Not anything about you.
Well, that's like brainwashing.
What do you mean brainwashing? He's just a machine.
You understand the city can't be responsible for additional funds inasmuch as he obviously failed our test situation.
If he failed, well, that's up to Officer Cleaver to tell us. Did he fail?
Well, what are you asking me for? What do I know from that stuff?
You know Haven. You know if you want him back the way he was.
Activated with all his old memory banks erased, there will be a Haven too. Perhaps better than this one.
Maybe not better. Maybe Officer Cleaver wants Haven back exactly the way he was. Knowing everything, remembering everything he was. In that case, he must tell us if Haven failed.
Think hard, Cleaver. I'm laying it on you. You want that clockwork joker back, you're stuck with him. Full time. All the time.
Yeah. I want him. All the time. But I want him back the way he was.
You know, every day I come home, my wife says, "How come you're happy and smiling all the time?" I tell her it's because I'm not working with Cleaver anymore.
Very funny. You want to bet the Colts or not?
I don't know. Let me think about it. Hey, I tell you what. How about your rookie against my rookie on the range tomorrow? $10.
Well, now, I'd like to think about it.
Can't handle it, huh?
For 20, I might. Of course,
I'd want you to check it out with your old lady. I wouldn't want you to get in over your head, you know.
I'm ready, sir. Say, you into sports?
Yes, sir.
Oh, that's good. What are you into?
Soccer.
Soccer.
Gonna be a nice day.
Oncoming low pressure area. 60% chance of precipitation.
No way.
You're probably right.
Good thinking. Yes, sir. We're going to get along just fine as long as you understand who the head honcho is. Honcher.
Yes, sir.
Haven, you know, back there at that wrecking yard, what I said about you and that metal compactor getting together, that was just a cheap shot. I didn't mean it. I'm sorry. You know, sometimes I think you machines really have it made. You're gonna be here long after I'm gone. And boy, the things you're gonna be able to see. Ooh, fantastic. I sure wish I could be there.
I'll send you a postcard.
Come on.
Exactly how well would you like me to shoot on the range tomorrow?
Nothing pushy. I figure maybe a 96 out of 100.
I have that. 96 out of 100.
Better make it 98. It's a pushy world out there, kid.
Magazine picked the Volkswagen Rabbit to be the best car in the world for under $3,500. Toyota, Datsun, Pinto, Vega, Honda, Fiat were all considered, but only the Volkswagen Rabbit made it. It's the best car in the world for under $3,500. You gotta drive it to believe it.
Thank goodness for Cycle 3. I never dreamed our dog was hiding a weight problem till our vet showed me where and why it's unhealthy. Now Sheba gets nothing but Cycle 3, the first food made for overweight dogs. It's a delicious, meaty dinner that's just as complete as the leading canned food, but with less fat and 20% fewer calories. With Cycle 3's help, soon she can be at her trim, healthy weight again.
Cycle Nutrition, for the life of your dog.
Sucking her thumb, and this is her brother trying to get her to stop.
Cut it out, Karen. Here, suck a lifesaver instead.
'Cause their great flavor has been around for years and years.
Go ahead, it's cherry. A lot better tasting than your thumb.
Lifesavers, the heart of
Lifesaver. Our dream house.
Yeah. Can't wait to move in.
Let's send everyone our new address.
But the house won't be ready for 6 weeks.
Look, we want our bank statements on time.
Yeah.
And our credit card.
Yeah.
And charge account bills.
You're right.
Your post office has a free change of address kit with cards to tell everyone exactly when you're moving.
Better make sure you tell everyone our right address.
Get the change of address kit from your post office or mailman. It makes things go smoother after you move.
Get ready for the Summer Olympic Games in swimming. Look for California's Laura Searing, best in the 200-meter breaststroke. 6'6" John Neighbor, winner of 8 NCAA titles in 3 years. Freestyle Shirley Babishaw, gold medal winner in the 72 Olympics. Tim Moore, Phi Beta Kappa graduate from Ohio State, swept the Nationals this winter. The Summer Olympic Games, up close and personal, the ABC way.
Tuesday night, live from Philadelphia.